Hi, and welcome back to the second part of Lesson 6, Level 3. In this last video of Lesson 6, we look at another option that the engineers have come up with as opposed to buying that fancy new million-dollar shoemaking machine. The engineers are proposing that we instead hire more labor and purchase a less expensive machine that does not have all the bells and whistles of the fancy machine. This less expensive equipment can be acquired, used, for only $250,000. In this new low sheet, we need to enter the details for this second option. We'll call it the manual labor option up here. If we go with this option, we only have to finance $250,000. Let's adjust these values up here to reflect the smaller loan and depreciation values. The salvage value is only $5,000, so it looks like we're going to run that machinery until it's just worth the value of the scrap metal. The tax rate stays the same, and the hurdle rate is still the same as well. This cheaper option does increase our labor rate per pair of shoes, so our cost of goods sold, or COGS, also increases up to $197.90 for year one. In our collective bargaining agreement with the Shoemakers Union, our labor rate increases yearly, and since this low capital option uses much more labor than the high capital option, we need to increase our cost of goods sold, or COGS, by 1% per year. Let me add a name up here in our name manager. We call it COGS inflation, and we'll give it a value of 1.01. In order to accommodate this COGS yearly rate inflation, I'm going to need to add a row in here that will calculate the COGS for each year since it changes each year. Let's give it a label of COGS per year. In year number one, we can just move this higher COGS rate per pair of shoes up to year one COGS rate cell. Now for year two, we need to put in a formula that will take our previous year's labor rate and then multiply it by that COGS inflation value of 1.01 that we created a minute ago. If we copy that formula to the right, these cells now accurately show us the projected rates for our COGS for the remaining years of this analysis. We'll now alter our cost of goods sold here to have the formula refer to the cell right above it, and then copy it across, and we're good to go. We now have a completely different set of numbers here for our income after taxes, and it looks like since we didn't borrow as much money and we're not paying FIDO as much interest, we're now generating a small profit in the very first year. Looking down here, all of the formulas that we created previously are now working with all of our new values up here with this low capital option. We also see that all of our net present values here are still positive. The internal rate of return is now 64%. The 5-year return on investment is now 544%. And the payback year is still somewhere in the third year. So with this second low capital option, we're generating a slightly larger return on investment. However, that projected profit is significantly less. See, the value here for the 25% hurdle rate is quite a bit less than our high option. The payback for both options happens in the third year, so not much of a difference there. It looks like in year five, the cash flow is actually less than it was in year four. That's because of our escalating labor rate. Our selling price is remaining constant, and our sales volume didn't increase much to accommodate the increasing costs. To summarize both of these two options, I've put all the results from the financial analyses into this table here for our financial analysts to look over. Both of these options will generate a significant profit, but in slightly different ways with varying levels of risk. Either way you win, but the answer chosen will most likely depend on which one is in alignment with the current culture of the zone or how much the zone is willing to gamble. That's it for Chapter 6. See you in Chapter 7.